Lab SSH. So we are focusing on how to install SSH and then how to do a key through this SSH server. So look, this scenario, we don't touch this scenario because this is a very good scenario. The only things that I remove from the previous scenario is this one, because you have an IP table here. I'm going to remove IP table here. So if you just do IP tables dash L, you see that we have drop. So you're dropping. So I remove that one, number one. So it's going to be like this. We had it. So it is on the forward and is number one. So I'm going to remove that one. Okay, so then if you look at L, there isn't anything, and you should have a ping from that the first one. Okay, so far so good. So this one acts like your server, this one acts like your client. So let's talk about SSH server. So if you want to install SSH, it's very easy. App get install open SSH-server. So it will install open SSH. By default, this version of Ubuntu that I am using, open SSH or SSH by default is enabled. But usually you can go app get install and then do this one. Where the configuration is located, you can do cd etc ssh and then ssh. If I cd here, look, there is like a configuration here, ssh d underline config. So nano ssh underline ssh d underline config. So this file basically is the configuration, the main configuration for your SSH. So like this one, by default port, SSH port is 22. So we can change it from here. For example, if I wanna change it to 2222, I can change it from here. So this part is talking about the public key and or the private key that you have, logging, authentication, how's gonna be the authentication that you have, authorized key, that we're gonna talk about authorized key also, and a lot of configuration like kbrowse and the other APIs that you wanna set. Also X, if you want to forward the X. The thing is that here, if you want to restart your services, you can do systemctl restart ssh.d.service. So then you can restart your service. So I configure that port number, I restart the services, and then look at the client. Now from the client, because this Linux 2 has the IP address of, look, if I show you again, if config. So I have two network interface. One of them is 192.168.1.1, right? So then I'm in a Linux one now. I can do this way, SSH username. So the username that I have here is, probably one of them is Ubuntu. Look, if I exit here, look, is Ubuntu. So I am using user Ubuntu, @ the IP address of the server 192.168.1.1 and the port number, because I have already changed the port number, so I put that one as 2222. So if you haven't changed the port number, then by default is 22. You don't need to specify the port number. So this one is SHA-256, is fingerprinting that you receive is a public key that you're receiving, and then you say yes. And then it's asking, what is the password you put here, Ubuntu? The version that I am here, it has like a screen like this. So it shows the password to you, but it's not very secure. So look, now I am in Linux 2. I did SSH. How can I verify? Look, if I do fconfig, look, it has two interfaces, the same as this one that I show you. So if I want to exit, look, if I exit, now session is closed and I am in the Linux 1. So if I show you here, look, this one is Linux 1 with this 192.168.1.10. So the way that we are doing is through the password. Like every time I should do this way, enter the password, and then I connect to the second Linux. But there is a way, another way, better way, that we can import the certificate. And when you're typing, for example, this way, you don't need to enter the password and automatically you will be connected to Linux 2. That's based on the keys. So we have two keys here. We have authorized keys, private key and a public key. Usually when we are using public key and a private key, we call this kind of encryption asymmetric. And that means that one of the keys is going to be shared. The other one is your private key and you keep that key. So to create the key, so you should have the key, right? So here, let me make sure that I am in Linux 1. So I close that terminal. I do sudo dash s. I am in a Linux 1. I verify with this IP address, I'm in Linux 1. And then I create or generate, maybe it's better to say generate, some keys, public key and the private key, which algorithm? RSA. So here is saying that, okay, the RSA algorithm, it will save the configuration, the files under here. You're okay? I'm saying, okay. If you want to put it on somewhere else, you can put it somewhere else. So you see that this folder is created here, directory is created. Do you want to create the passphrase? This is another password that you can add to your key. Well, I just want to leave it as default. I click on enter. Enter the same passphrase. Okay. You see that I just keep it as blank. Do not put any password. So then RSA password created for you. So you can change your directory. You can go to this directory. You can copy this one, CD, and paste it here. And then LS, you see that we have RSA, public key and the private key. Which one is a public key and which one is the private key? Probably that one has the extension of a public ID underline. If I cat ID underline RSA.pub, look, this one is my public key. But the other one is ID underscore RSA is my private key. You see that is calling private key. And I can't read that one. Also, I can't read this part because it's encoded and encrypted, so I cannot read any part. So now I'm gonna copy these keys, these two keys, these keys on my server. On Linux 2. So what's gonna happen? Because the second Linux has my key and the public key, so it allows me to connect to the second Linux without using any password. So the command is like this, SSH dash copy dash ID and the username. Username was Ubuntu. And the remote IP address was 192.168.1.1. Because we are using another port, you can use this port. Probably I should put somewhere else. That's P. After here. Dash P. I should put it here. 1.1. dash P 2222 and Ubuntu 192.168.1.1. You see that? So then yes, what is the password? Ubuntu. Ubuntu. Okay. Number of a key added. Now try to make so the key added to my server. Okay. So now how can I verify my connection? Let's verify. Let's check it again. Look, I am in Linux one. Okay. So if I do this command, what was that before? Oh, we didn't have SSH Ubuntu 192.168.1.1 and dash P 2222 like this. So I should receive a password, but I didn't receive any password. And now look, if config, I'm in Linux 2. Without asking any password, I'm in Linux 2. Why? Because I copied my keys here. And keys should be located somewhere under, probably under cd slash dot ssh. We have or ssh. So here, look, cat authorized key. Look, that's the RSA copy key, a public key copied here. So now it knows this. Look, it belongs to this IP address. The good thing is that if you have a like 10 clients or 100 clients, they can copy their keys here. And without asking any password, they can connect to the server. And that's the beauty of using keys when you're doing this way. You know, the old method is based on the password, but this is a very good one. So many cloud technology nowadays, they are using this way. They're using keys to connect to your machine in the cloud. Basically, that's the lab of the SSH.